Hi, my name is Lance Harrop, and I am the Dean of Students at Arizona State University's Polytechnic Campus and Executive Director for the Disability Resource Center. My primary role is supporting student success, so any student that comes to us in terms of engagement and opportunities for us to help students be successful at the university, that's my role. As the Executive Director for the Disability Resource Center, we work with a number of students with disabilities to ensure that they have access to the full experience of Arizona State University. So the Disability Resource Center facilitates access for students with disabilities as they come to ASU. Many of our students that are coming here that have disabilities, they might need accommodations or services or other support. So we have students with learning disabilities or attention deficit hyperactivity disorders, psychiatric disabilities, physical disabilities, whatever the case may be. We work individually with each student to ensure that they're receiving the services and accommodations that they need to be successful. I would say that the two primary myths that we see relative to prospective students and parents and families as they come from high school to college. The first being that the experience of requesting accommodations is the same in high school and college, which is not the case. So in high school, it's very different. The responsibility of identifying the services and supporting students fall to the school and to the teachers that are working with students. But as students transition to Arizona State University and or the collegiate level, the responsibility of identifying those services and requesting the services fall to the student. So that's an important distinction. And that's why the DRC is an important resource for students to help students navigate that distinction and the difference in the transition from high school to college. I would say that the second myth that still persists is that students with disabilities are limited in terms of their potential because they have a disability, which is simply not true. We have students that are part of every college across the entire university and are achieving at very high levels, are very successful, and are doing phenomenal things both within ASU and then as they leave ASU and go back to the communities for which they're part of, continuing to contribute at very high levels within those communities as well. So the notion that a student, because they have a disability, can't achieve at the same level as somebody who does not have a disability is just simply not true. Just be excited about their students. Be excited about encouraging the students to participate and engage in the full experience of Arizona State University, and encourage their students to get connected to different resources, including the Disability Resource Center. Many of our students, they may not need accommodations, or there might be a class where accommodations are needed, but they might have a class where accommodations aren't needed. Even if students are not using accommodations, there are other resources and services and skills that we can help students continue to develop. We can help students be engaged in the full ASU experience. And it's always better to start that experience or that process of registering with the DRC early on. So if there is a need later on in the semester or later on in their ASU experience, that we're ready to go. There is no better advocate for a student with a disability than that person who has the disability. No one understands the impact of the disability better than the person who has it. While teachers and parents and family and administrators and coordinators and support services are great advocates and we are here to support and do whatever it is that we can to help you be successful, you being able to advocate for yourself and understand and be comfortable with that is an important process, not just at ASU, not just in as part of your collegiate experience, but that's a lifelong skill. And as parents, I would say it's important to help your students to develop those self-advocacy skills early on, to be confident with themselves, to be proud of who they are, and to learn those communication skills and talking about the impact of their disability and what are those things that we can do to help support them.